Welcome back to another exciting week of high school basketball. This is Blair Dugre along with our resident coach, Lori May, bringing you more exciting high school basketball from the St. John's Gymnasium. This week we bring you freshman and varsity action in city conference play of the North Division. We'll see in the first game, the St. John's Tigers and Tech Bock Hornets freshman teams take part. St. John's is currently ranked number 3 in the province, while Tech Bock is ranked number 4. Coach May, what do you expect to see from these two teams in this freshman action coming up?
Well, with both these teams being ranked in the top 5, I expect to see a very good game. Both teams have excellent guards that can handle the ball, and they also have very big men inside as well. I expect to see an excellent basketball game here tonight.
All right, we're about 45 seconds away from the starting of this game. We'll give you the starting lineups for both the St. John's Tigers and the Tech Bock Hornets. First for the visiting team on our scoreboard is Tech Bock Hornets. They'll be starting number 5 at guard, 5'5", Cesar Tanako. Playing the other guard position at 5'11", number 14, Dwayne Trickett. Forward positions will be number 21, Chris Bell at 5'10". Another guard forward will be number 22, Glenroy Wheeler at 5'11". And starting in the forward position at 6'even", number 15, Ron Burley. They're coached by Joe DiCurzio. Taking a look now at the Tech Bock players. The St. John's Tigers will be coming onto the floor. Number 10, playing at forward, 6', Richard Petrie. Number 15, William Ignacio. He's starting at one of the forward positions. 20, Run, Rick Trulinski, another forward. Larry Wandowicz at 6'2", number 22 will also be starting for them, and number 11 at guard, Celso Castries, will be starting for the St. John's Tigers. We get ready to start the floor. Referee Charlie the Bird Kurtz, will be throwing up the ball along with Irv Teddy Bear Hennick. Opening tip-off is controlled by the St. John's Tigers. Quickly they move up court. Shot, first shot of the game, number 15, Rowan Ignacio hits for 2 points.
After that first basket, we can see that St. John's intends to really beat the tempo of this game. If we can have a look right here, you can see Roland Ignacio going right to the hole. Kids aren't afraid to drive at it at all.
Tech Bock Hornets in control of the ball right now. Cesar Tanako, number 5, a 5'5" guard. He comes from General Wolf Junior High. He's setting up the play, trying to move the ball inside. Right now, at the beginning of this, we've started to play about a minute. Right now, and it's all tied up at 2 all. Number 14, Dwayne Trickett, hits on the outside. First 2 points.
Dwayne Trickett, probably one of the best shooting freshman players that we have in this city right now. As we can see tonight, Coach DiCurzio has moved him into playing forward and out of the guard spot.
Quickly, there's a steal by the Hornets. They come up. Number 15, that pull-away jumper. Ron Burley takes it away. His shot won't go when the ball goes out of bounds. Quickly, St. John's tries to fire that one up court. And they're lucky there that the referee, Kurtz, blew that whistle down, because St. John's would have lost control. Early man-on-man pressure being put on by the Hornets. Ignacio drives inside again for 2 points, and we got a foul.
Good defense there by number 15, Ron Burley, as he stood in there and took the charge. What they're going to have to do, the Hornets, that is to stop that easy penetration by Roland Ignacio.
No basket there. Is offensive foul by number 15, Roland Ignacio. That's his first personal, the team's first of this half. Right now, the Tech Bock Hornets are in control of the ball. Number 5, Cesar Tanako. Number 21 gets that pass inside for Tech Bock. Chris Bell, he hits first, 2 points.
Chris Bell, another fine young freshman athlete that has gone to Tech Bock from system out of General Wolf. His senior coach there, Rick Hudson, does a fantastic job with these young men.
Get the ball inside. We're going to have our first shooting foul down underneath. Number 22 is going to go to the line. Larry Wandowicz.
Freshman mistake there by Dwayne Trickett. The inside position was taken by Larry Wandowicz, and he should have either just let him shoot the ball there.
Dwayne Trickett picking up his first personal, the team's first of this half. Sends number 22, Wandowicz, to the line. He misses the first, he's got one more. He misses them both to the line, fighting for the rebound. St. John's managed to come away with it, they lose control, and quickly Trickett pulls away. Trickett looking to get that ball inside to Tanako, but the play was stopped. He pulls it back, and Tech Bock Hornets going to set up their offense. They're leading 4-2. We've played just over 2 minutes now in this first quarter. Get the ball inside to Bell once again. He tried to in-turn to the basket. He lost control, but it went off the foot of one of St. John's players.
Number 15 for St. John's, Roland Ignacio, is going to have his hands full trying to watch Chris Bell underneath. What Coach DiCurzio has done is to post Chris Bell low, and I think that could be a very key factor in the outcome of the game.
Now, man-on-man defense being played. Chris Bell gets that ball, feeds it off. Shot from the outside by Burley. It won't go. Bell fighting for the rebound. We got a foul underneath. That matchup Coach Mays talked about already has affected the St. John's Tigers down low. Take a look at this foul, last foul on replay by number 11. It's also Castries picking up the foul.
Here we can see we're going to have a little bit of trouble. Roland Ignacio manages to stop Chris Bell eventually, but Chris manages to get the board. I think that's going to be one of the key matchups of the game, because if Coach Araska has to move Roland Ignacio off of Chris Bell and bring in either Larry Wandwich or one of the other big people to watch him, it's going to leave Chris Bell even freer than he is right now.
Also, Castries picking up his first personal foul for the Tigers. That's the team's second of this half. We played 2 minutes and 20 seconds, 4-2. Tecvalk up in front by 2 points. We're taking a look right now at the Tecvalk Hornets bench. Moving over, of course, with Coach Rick Araska right now in St. John's Tigers. Both teams coming back out onto the floor. Number 21, Chris Bell, is going to go to the line to shoot two. He's looking for his third and fourth points of the game with these two free throws.
Number 21, Chris Bell, is without a doubt the finest athlete to have come out of General Wolfe this past year. And not only does he show his prowess on the basketball floor, but he's also quite a track star as well.
That pass goes upstairs. A long down court pass. Number 11, Sasso Castries, he's picking up his first 2 points on that pass.
Good look by St. John's to take the easy basket down at this end of the floor. Tecvalk can ill afford to give St. John's something as easy as that.
Looking at the third and fourth ranked teams in the province right now. St. John's in third. Tecvalk fourth, right inside by Trickett. And he's fouled down low. Take a look at that foul down low, if we can catch that on replay.
If we have a look here, here on our replay, if we get a chance, we're going to see a good move here by Dwayne Trickett as he takes Richard Petrie, I should say, baseline. Accepts the ball well, good fake, goes baseline, draws the foul.
Trickett missing on the first of two. Petrie picked up his first personal. That's the team's third of this half. Trickett misses them both through the line. Fighting down low for the rebound. Looks like we're going to have a jump ball.
Good hustle there by number 15, Ron Burley of the Tecvalk Hornets. At this particular time, we're looking at the Hornets just with a single point advantage. If they had been shooting their foul shots a little bit better, they could easily be up to a 6 or 7 point lead at this point of the game.
Early, Yuskulinski, Trickett from the outside. The shot won't go, and the ball's knocked out of bounds once again by the Tigers. Hornets have a chance to go up by three. The ball's knocked away, but Tecvalk managed to gain control. 4 minutes, 50 seconds remaining. A 1 point lead for the Hornets and control of the ball. Cesar Tanako has control at the top of the key. Then Roy Wheeler right now tried to get it inside. The ball's knocked away, but Chris Bell is there to take it. He takes that short jumper for 2 points. Chris Bell now has 5 points in the game.
Chris Bell now has five of Tecvalk's 7 points. And as I was saying earlier, this is going to be the man that St. John's Tigers are going to have to stop if they're going to stay straight man to man.
But we see St. John's go into zone type of defense if they keep getting the ball inside to Chris Bell.
If Roland Ignacio can't front Chris Bell a little bit better than that and make the ball a little bit more hard for him to receive, Coach Arras is going to have to do something. Either move over one of the other big men or simply go into some type of a zone. I expect him to go into a 2-3 zone if they played earlier.
Good ball movement by the Tigers. They get the ball around. Larry Wandowicz picks up his first 2 points. We're seeing early pressure now by the St. John's Tigers. The ball's knocked away. They managed to get it back. Tanako brings it across the 10-second line. He's going to set up his offense with the Hornets leading 7-6. 1 point lead. Larry Duguay along with Laurie May watching the best in high school basketball here on BPW 13 Sports. Good play there by number 15 Burley to throw that one off of Wandowicz. Tecvalk's going to gain control underneath the basket.
Smart move there by number 15, Ron Burley. What he did is just saved an out-of-bounds situation for his team. This is the little man here, Cesar Tinanco, is doing a good job in controlling this offense for the Hornets. What they've got to do is, however, is move the ball a little bit quicker, get some more ball movement, and they're going to get Chris Bell underneath more, even more so than they have thus far in the beginning of the game.
Good ball there. The ball's going to go out the side to the Hornets. They're up by 1 point. We've got 3 minutes and 23 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Chris Bell's going to inbound the ball. He stepped on the line. A little bit of a mental mistake, and quickly, John's going to come away, slow the play up a little bit, get the ball inbounds. They're going to set up their offense. What kind of things are St. John's looking to do? Trying to get it inside, or they're trying to hit the open man in the corner?
St. John's going to try and get the ball down inside. They got a couple of really big people there in number 22, Larry Wondowicz, and number 15, Tiberio.
Celso Castries hitting from the outside. He now has 4 points. Good thing got a high ceiling here, because he really threw that one up there. 8-7, first lead of the game for the St. John's Tigers since the early moments when they scored that breakaway basket. Once away, they come away with that quick pass, they get it up. Castros pulls up at the free throw line, takes a shot, it rims but won't fall down. That ball comes the other way, they're starting to run a little bit now. Armbrugge does a smart thing and slows it down for the Hornets. They're gonna set up Trickett, sees a little opening, drives towards the basket. 2 points, a good move by number 14, Dwayne Trickett.
Good first quick step there by Dwayne Trickett. What he did is just as he had done earlier along the baseline. Good inside move there to number 21, Rick Twilinski. What the St. John's can do is a lot of damage if they can get it into their three big men, number 10, Richard Petrie, along with Wodanowicz and...
Back from the outside there, number 5, Cesar Tinanco, picks up his first 2 points, and quickly St. John's tries to come the other way. This time, number 22, Lenroy Wheeler was there to intercept that pass, gets it up to Trickett. It looks for that shot, decides to feed it back out again. 11-10, that's our fifth lead change now in the game. Hefbach out in front by 1 point. We've got a minute and 40 seconds now remaining. Twickett drives towards the baseline, falls underneath. Took a little extra step though as he stepped underneath to get into the opening quickly once again. St. John's is firing that ball down court the last two times though. It has not worked for them. They've lost control.
Hefbach is going to have to start looking at the ball as they come back. They've been caught three or four times, and fortunately for Coach DiCurzio, Roland Ignacio just couldn't handle that pass. Otherwise, it would have been another easy 2 points for the Tigers.
St. John's, good job of hustle. Our first sub coming into the game, number 10, Gerard Murphy. He'll be replacing number 22, Glenmore Wheeler, for the Tecpac Hornets. Gerard Murphy, 5'9" guard out of Andrew Minarski. Almost a shot from the outside. Nocco pulls it back out, gets it to Murphy, takes his first shot of the game, coming off the bench, it won't go. Nocco's there for the rebound, tried to get it inside. That was knocked out of bounds once again by the Tigers. A lot of movement to get the ball back out. Down to a minute and 10 now remaining. 11-10, a 1 point lead for the Hornets. Expect to see a close game throughout here. Burley from the outside, 2 points, a nice shot there by number 15, Ron Burley, for his first 2 points of the game.
Good job there by number 15, Ron Burley. He took the ball right at Rick Twilinski and made Twilinski back up and then took himself a nice 12, 14 foot jump shot.
Get the ball inside, nice feed off Matt Wondowicz, moves towards inside. Suddenly that was Rick Twilinski picking up his 4th point of the game. Nice feed pass from Petrie. Seeing that pressure again being set up here by the Tigers.
Good pressure, primary pressure by the St. John's Tigers. What's going to have to happen for Coach Araska to make that pressure work a little bit better is his big men in the back of this pressure are going to have to come up a little bit.
Nocco moves inside, tries to get the Burley, carried that ball. So turnover, 13-12, 1 point lead for the Hornets. Tigers have control of the ball. Looks like they're going to play for one shot as we move in 20 seconds. Number 11, though, sees a little opening and drives for 3 points. So Castries picking up his 6th point of the game and a nice drive inside. We've got 10 seconds. We've got 6 lead changes now in the game. Expect this to be a back and forth battle. There's that first steal almost off of that pressure. Ball's knocked out of bounds, and what that's going to do, though, is run the time off the clock in the first quarter. So good job by the St. John's Tigers and the pressure they've been looking to get control of that ball and a steal. Finally worked for them as taking away the opportunity for the Hornets to come back and regain the lead. Coach May, what you expected in the first quarter from these two freshman teams?
This is a very good first quarter of ball. What we can have is in that last basket right here, what we can see is some excellent movement by St. John's Tigers. What St. John's has done is they've been able to get the ball inside very well. Also, we've got good pressure from the Tigers in terms of Celso Castres and number 15, Roland Ignacio. They are bigger than the guards for Tech Bock. What we might see is Coach DiCurzio try and counter this by bringing Wayne Trickett out of the forward position and perhaps giving him the ball and working him out of a guard position, as he has done most of the time this year. The other thing that the Hornets are going to have to do is they're going to have to see the ball on their way back in defense. They've been caught three or four times, and it's resulted in three or four easy layups by the Tigers. The Tigers, on the other hand, they're playing a real good man-to-man defense, and it's something that I really like to see. Too many of the ball teams in the city play zone, which can lead to very low-scoring games and somewhat boring basketball. This first quarter of this freshman game, however, has been extremely entertaining, and it's just what we expect.
Good work by both teams, the St. John's Tigers and the Tech Bock Hornets. Score after one quarter of play is St. John's 14, Tech Bock 13. Getting set now to come out for the second quarter. Only had one substitution so far in the game, and that was by the Tech Bock team. Gerard Murphy came in to replace one of the Tech Bock players. He came to replace Lenoir Wheeler. Coming back out right now, St. John's and Tech Bock getting ready to jump this ball. Lee Kurtz throws it up, the ball's knocked away, and is in control of the Hornets. Get a chance to regain that lead once again. We're expecting the battle to go back and forth. We've got six lead changes already. Tech Bock is going to try to make it seven and pull a one-point lead. Trickett's open on the outside. They don't want to leave him open.
Good adjustment there by Coach DiCurzio against the man-to-man. He's gone to a 1-2-2 offense, and what he's done is he's taken Dwayne Trickett off the baseline and put him out there on the shooting wing, and as we can see, he's very successful. It's going to have to draw the man-to-man out. They can't give Dwayne Trickett that much room.
Wondowich right now in control of the ball. They throw it in. They get it inside once again. Looking to move that ball around. There's number 10 there. Beatrice's shot won't go. Fighting for that rebound is 21. Zielinski, he picks up his sixth point of the game with that basket.
Good strong offensive board by number 21, Rick Chulinski.
There's that pressure. It's second turnover now being forced on St. John's Tigers. They gain control. They've got a chance to take their largest lead of the game. They lead by one right now. There's a quick shot from the outside. It won't go down. Number 15, Roland Ignacio taking that shot quickly. Tech Bock throws the ball away at the other end of the court.
Good job by St. John's on that pressure. As we said before, that primary pressure is there and it's very tough. All St. John's needs is a couple of their big men to come up from the back, and they'll be able to handle it very easily.
Forced by Trickett there, caused that turnover. Number 4, Benner Tenario, picking up that traveling violation. He has just entered the game. Inside 7 minutes now remaining here. Shot from the outside. Murphy's shot hits for 2 points. Lord Murphy picking up his first 2 points of the game. Now the pressure's at the other end of the court. Seeing pressure now from the Tech Bock Hornets, bringing the ball up. Evan Ariel will get it. He's got a little push from behind. Number 23 picking up that foul. Mike DeLorme for the Hornets. That's his first personal, the team's second.
Good series of play there. First of all, the good basket by Murphy, and good following man-to-man press by the Hornets, and then it was broken very well by the Tigers. Unfortunately, they've just thrown it away there.
Taking that shot from the outside there, number 23, who just picked up that foul. DeLorean, it won't fall down. And quickly, the Tigers come the other way. Tigers like to run up that court. That shot was forced a little bit. Came up a little short, and once again, the Hornets come back. They've got a one-point lead. They can expand that to three. They've led by 2 points at one time. They've never led by more than two. On the other side, they try to get inside to Burley. Burley's down on the baseline. Keep moving the ball around. They're looking for that open shot. They get it down underneath the Trickett. Trickett off the glass for 2 points. Trickett hitting from inside and out. Causing a lot of damage for the Hornets.
Good ball movement there by the Hornets to find Dwayne Trickett open underneath. And then here we've got good pressure to cause a turnover.
Point lead right now, 5 minutes, 50 seconds. That shot from the outside won't fall down. St. John's comes away with the rebound. Zielinski brings the ball across, sees an opening, drives towards the middle. He could pick up a charging foul. Pick picked up that charging foul as he went inside. The position was down. I think that was Burley underneath with the position, but we'll take a look and make sure on replay and exactly what happened there on that charge.
What we're going to see here is some good positioning by number 15, Ron Burley. Terlinski's getting caught in the midcourt, a big man trying to dribble the ball, and Ron Burley just stands there and takes the charge. The basket doesn't count, and it's a turnover in favor of the Techlock Hornets.
Some of the younger players out there, that's the position you want to get. He knew he was going to go down, he knew he was going to get hit, but he stood in there and took the charge to get his team the ball. Shot from the outside, Murphy from that free throw line. It won't fall down, and quickly, St. John's, they'd like to get that ball up court very quickly. Castos pushes off. Looks like we're going to have a blocking foul, though, on number five. Zartanako picking up his first personal foul, the team's third of this half.
What's happened here is...
We're going to see that again once on replay, the blocking not getting position this time.
Good feed. Fantano just, he's moving, his feet are still moving. He doesn't get the position, and the foul, of course, is before the shot, so the 2 points don't count.
Castries from the outside. He sort of rifled that one up for 2 points. He now has eight. He leads all scorers in the game with 8 points. Roy Wheeler tried to bounce that one back to Knocker. It goes out of bounds. St. John's now has a chance to regain the lead. They trail by one with 5 minutes and 10 seconds remaining in this first half.
Good pressure once again by St. John's, and what they're managing to do is they're managing to get the ball in the hands of the big men for Techlock, and they're carrying it up against the press. It's not working.
Good follow through by number 10, Richard Petrie. Took his own shot, fouled in for the rebound, which young players don't usually do, but he fouled right in, got his own rebound, scored 2 points. His first 2 points of the game, and his team has a 1 point lead, 20-19. Tigers over the Hornets. Early from the baseline, it won't go down. Quickly, they fire that ball up court again, and they lose control.
Ron Burley, once again, is doing some damage for the Hornets along the baseline. They're going to have to cut that off.
Wheeler from the outside, his shot won't go, fighting for the rebound. Linsky comes away with it. And that ball up against pressure. Need the ball in the corner. Glenroy Wheeler's there. They take it away. Ball down inside. Trelinski with a little turnaround. Take a hook shot for 2 points. We got a timeout now by the Techlock Hornets with 4 minutes and 5 seconds remaining. 22-19, 3-point lead for the Tigers over the Hornets, their largest lead of the game.
On the last basket, a good turnaround jumper by number 21, Rick Trelinski. However, he had gotten into trouble earlier, just as the Techlock players had gotten into trouble a little bit earlier. And that's, we've got the big forwards trying to bring up the ball. What they've got to do is once they rebound, they've got to start on both teams to dish the ball off to the two little guards on either team and to make sure that they bring the ball up and get themselves positioned. What we can see is one of the big changes in the game, of course, has been the fact that Rick Haraska for St. John's has had his team playing, four of his ball players playing a 1-3 zone, and he's brought in number 14, Julio Acuna, and Acuna is playing Dwayne Trickett man-to-man and has thus far in the last 2 minutes shut him off. Coach DeCurzy, of course, taking a timeout to try and help his team break that 2-2-1 pressure that the St. John's Tigers have changed to from the man-to-man press that they saw earlier in the game.
Saw a little earlier there on our screen the supporters for the St. John's Tigers and their banner. Didn't quite get to read the banner, but I know it's in favor of the St. John's Tigers. So St. John's number one, usually a very supportive crowd for the St. John's Tigers. As Coach Wedlake has built up quite a program, we'll see him in the varsity game coming up immediately following this game. Well, varsity boys action between the Hornets and the Tigers. Right now, 2 minutes, 50 seconds remaining. The freshman boys are playing on the court. Number 23 taking that shot up for the Tigers, Mike DeLorme, and it won't fall down. St. John's comes the other way with a 3-point lead. They've got a chance to move it to five. Astros open the corner. Nice move towards the baseline, and he's rejected underneath. The Trickett's going to pick up that foul as he hit him from behind.
Good job by number 11, Celso Gastry. He made a good fake and took Ron Burley in the air. Dwayne Trickett trying to get back to help out, but instead of trying to position his body, he tried to block his shot and picked up a very foolish foul.
Trickett picked up his second personal foul. That's the team's fourth of this half. Only member of the St. John's freshman team that did not play his freshman basketball for the Tigers. The junior high school, he played football. Started to be at Glenlawn Collegiate and transferred over to St. John's here. His family moved into this area. Castro's hit them both from the line, and he now has 10 points in the game, and there's another steal by the Tigers. They're starting to run away a little bit with this one. Ball's taken inside, offensive rebound, but it's blocked underneath. Trickett comes away for the Hornets.
The Tekfa corners are having definitely having trouble with that 2-2-1 pressure that's being applied by the Tigers. Here we get a look at what's happening in terms of defense against the Hornets, with St. John's having four members of their team playing zone and Julio Acuna playing Dwayne Trickett man-to-man. However, what they did there was all managed to get to one side of the floor, and we had Ray DeLorme with a very easy layup on the other side.
Ray DeLorme all by himself for 2 points. Castrizo comes back at the other end, and he now has 12. Also, Castries picking up his 12th point in the game, and that shot from the outside. He's countering all the attacks. 5-point lead right now. Nice move inside by Burley, and he's fouled underneath. Number 21 is going to pick up that foul, Rick Dolinsky. That's his second personal foul, the team's fifth. He's going to send number 15, Ron Burley, of the Hornets, to the line to shoot two.
Good job there by Ron Burley. What we're going to see here, hopefully, if we can get a replay, this is the good, quick first step.
To have this basket first, and then take a look at that last one on replay, and there's Ron Burley. Here we go. Just saw the tail end of that going inside Burley, and now Burley's got his second shot. Misses the second one from the line. St. John's comes away with it. Nice pass outside. Castry steps inside, pulls that one off the glass. It won't go. Dolinsky's inside. His shot won't go. St. John's is doing a good job of getting down inside for those offensive rebounds.
Two big men for St. John's, number 22, Larry Radonowicz, and number 21, Rick Dolinsky, are doing a good job on the boards.
23 picking up that foul for St. John's Tigers. Wayne Antonishin has just come into the game. He picks up his first personal foul. That's going to send Mike DeLorme to the line to shoot two. Coming back into the game, Richard Petrie. He replaces number 22, Antonishin. He just picked up that foul.
Tekfa continues to have trouble at the foul line. In the first quarter, they missed four or five very precious foul shots.
Makes that first one. No shot, the violation, and that accuse on the board. 26-22, 2 minutes and 22 seconds remaining in the first half. 4-point lead for the Tigers, and they're in control right now. Control the ball quickly to get that ball across the midcourt line. Yokuna gets that ball down inside. The ball's taken away. Going down hard is Wondowicz. He's still down on the floor, and we're going to have a stoppage in play. Seemed to hurt the side of his leg as he came down. Raskin comes off the floor. Take a look and
good
see
follow to the board by number 22, Larry Wondowicz. What happened, of course, is when he went up for the ball, he came down and landed as he was bumped by number 15, Ron Burley, and we sustained a little bit of an ankle injury. What they were going to need is they're going to need him in there because he's one big man. He's going to be replaced by number 24, Tony Silk, who comes in at 6 feet even.
So St. John's Junior High at 6 foot has come in to play the forward position. We see them in a 2-3 zone right now. It's not really a 2-3 zone, as Coach May mentioned. It's a four-man zone, a little 4-and-1 or 4-and-a-box, they call it. Or box and one, pardon me. I'll get the terminology right. Wheeler moves inside, takes that shot. It goes off the back iron and won't come down. Quickly, Julio Aquino gets the ball down inside. Number 24 who just entered the game. Tony Self takes that shot. 2 points. Nice move inside. Good action here in the first quarter. Murphy from the outside. His shot won't go. Credit for the rebound. Good position there by the Tigers, and they come away with the ball.
Good job by the St. John's in terms of the defensive boards. What they've done is they've shut the Hornets right off, and the Hornets are only getting one shot. They're getting shots. Good move inside. Nice beat by number 10, Richard Petrie, to number 21, Rick Terlinski.
Terlinski hits for 2 points. We've got a timeout once again by the Hornets. Coach DiCurzio is not too happy with his troops as he pulls them off. That's their second timeout of the half. That'll be the last one that they have. There's Coach DiCurzio on your screen right now. And what might he be saying to his players, Coach May?
What he's going to have to do, he's going to have to tell them, first of all, that when St. John's does score, they're coming at them with a 2-2-1 zone press. They're no longer going man-to-man. That's causing the Hornets problems. On the offensive end, the other thing he has to tell his men, he's got to have to get a little bit more ball movement. With St. John's sitting four people in the zone and one other player, that is to say number 14, Julio Acuna, playing Dwayne Trickett man-to-man, the Hornets, what they're doing is they're playing into St. John's hands by just simply holding the ball and not moving it enough. They've got to just pretend that they're playing against, as you said earlier, something that looks like a 2-3 zone and get a lot more ball movement on their offense. Otherwise, they're down 8 right now with a minute and 14 seconds left in the first half. And unless they start to get some action going, they're going to be down a lot more before halftime.
Down to a minute and 10 seconds now remaining. If we can set up what looks like at 2-3, that box in one, maybe you can explain to us exactly what the purpose of that is after the shot here by Lauren that goes out. It's going to go off one of the Tech Bock players and then it bounce to St. John's. What is the reasoning that St. John's has gone to this box in one?
As far as St. John's is concerned here, or at least Coach Harask is, he believes that in the zone he can cut off some of the quicker penetration by players such as Ron Burley. And then by doing so, he thinks he's taking care of the baseline. And the other thing he wants to stop is Dwayne Trickett from outside. So he's just going to simply let one person go at him, man on man, usually his best defensive player.
Good move from the baseline, number 15, Ron Burley. He now has 5 points, 30 to 24. There's a steal by Trickett. Dwayne Trickett picking up his 10th point of the game. A nice steal underneath, and that pressure now. A lot of pressure being put on by the Hornets to try to get themselves back in as we move down with inside 20 seconds. St. John's managed to break that pressure. A little short jumper by Self. It won't go. Self followed in on his own shot, what he should do, but he ran right into Burley. And that's going to send Burley down to the bonus line.
Big series of plays there. First of all, what we had is after the timeout, we had Coach DiCurzio substituting in a lot of his bench players, but at the same time, a lot quicker players. Right now, with 18 seconds left in the game, you can see that the score is 30 to 26 in favor of the St. John's Tiger. What we had with the introduction of these quicker players into the game, it allowed a couple back-to-back steals by the Hornets. And if Ron Burley can hit here, which he does, it's going to draw the Hornets very, very close. Mr. Silk, when he came down there with 20 seconds left, should have held the ball for one shot. And unfortunately for the Tigers, he did not.
Burley can't hit the second one. He now has 6 points in the game. The score is 30 to 27. But a minute ago, the score was 30 to 22. 8-point lead is the window down to 3 points. St. John's has control. They're going to try to get a shot with one shot. The clock's not working. No, someone forgot to start the clock, so there's still quite a bit of time left on it. Down only 13 seconds. That play took 5 seconds, and I think there was a little bit of a problem. But sometimes that happens. They have a lot of trouble sometimes of getting some minor officials to come out.
What happened here for St. John's, although the clock did not start, it ended up working out to Tech Vox's favor because down in the ensuing end, we had a foul that was picked up and will put St. John's, I should say Tech Vox, to the bonus line. What we have here, of course, is a situation where the Tech Vox coordinates are going to be very fortunate near the end of this half. Hopefully they'll be able to hit these two and draw within 1 point, and St. John's will have just 13 seconds left to try and get themselves a 3-point lead back again.
13 seconds remaining, 30 to 27. We're going to go the line once again. The Hornets have a chance to move within 1 point as they come down to shoot the bonus. And there were 18 seconds remaining, and the clock did not run for a few seconds. And sometimes that happens as minor officials are not picked from the league. They're trained within the schools, and it's very easy for a person to sometimes get caught up in what's going on in the game and forget to start the clock. I mean, it happens in a lot of different school gymnasiums. Right now, it's going to work to the advantage of the Hornets. But with 13 seconds remaining and St. John's can get the ball back, they've got lots of time to come down and score at the other end. 30 to 27, 13 seconds remaining in this first half.
Minor officials have been a problem in many of the games throughout the Winnipeg High School League. What I would like to see is something that I know Coach Bill Wedlake, who coaches the varsity team here at St. John's, would like to see, and that would be a minor officials clinic that is put on every year. What I would like to see is the jobs of the minor officials promoted, and maybe one of the things that the league might think of doing is paying these minor officials for the time that they put in.
Yes, it is a very important job. They do a good job. That shot's knocked away. St. John's managed to come away with it, so the chance, but they lose control. Burley from the key throws that one up and it won't come down. We're down with inside 5 seconds. Ball's thrown down, but it hits the ceiling here. It's going to go out of bounds to the Hornets. We've got 6 seconds remaining. Tech Vox has a chance to move within one with a basket here, if they can do it in the last 6 seconds.
A real good job here by the Tech Vox Hornets in the last minute and 20 seconds of this game.
DeLorme at the buzzer for 2 points. That's it, the end of the first half. The score, the St. John's Tigers 30, the Tech Vox Hornets 29. A good shot there. And number 23, Mike DeLorme, he now has 4 points. Coach, may your comments on that first half.
The first half was went the way that I expected. We've got two very good teams here, both ranked in the top five. Tech Vox was a little bit frustrated near the end of the half as they had trouble handling the 2-2-1 zone press that was being applied by the Tigers, and they had a little problem in the offensive zone. as far as St. John's is concerned, they did a lot of good things defensively, and they also did some good things offensively, getting the ball into the hands of people like Rick Chlorinsky and Larry Wodonowicz, and at the same time, the outside game complemented that inside game with shots by Celso Zastri. However, they did come unglued a little bit in the last 2 minutes, and they've allowed Tech Valk back in this game. They had them by 8 points and easily could have been up by 14, perhaps even 16 at the half. But all credit to Coach DiCurzio and his adjustment, and I expect to see a very good second half.
Well, with a minute and 10 seconds remaining in this first half, the score was 30-22, an 8-point lead. It's now 30-29. We'll be back in a moment with more exciting high school basketball action from the St. John's Gymnasium.
VPW, Channel 13, west of the red.
Now, according to these latest time and motion,
the building is closed.
My dad works here.
I wanted to point... Freddie, what are you doing here?
Daddy, is time really worth money?
Well, yes, it is.
Well, I like to play ball after supper.
Time is priceless. The Bible says our days are numbered. Are you shortchanging your family?
Second half of the freshman boys action between the St. John's Tigers and the Tech Valk Hornets. We'll be ready to go in about a minute from time from now. St. John's currently out in front, 30-29. Coach May, we're going to see anything different in the second half from both teams.
What I expect to see in the second half is a continuation of the pressure that the St. John Tigers have used to, first of all, they got them in the lead. But at the same time, unfortunately for the Tigers, they did slip in the final minute and a half of the game, and they've let the Hornets back in. As far as the Hornets are concerned, I expect to see Coach DiCurzio expect a lot more pressure from his players, and I expect to see them try to upbeat the tempo of this game, as they've been very successful when they've been in complete control. However, I don't think that they've quite yet played against a team that has put things together such as the St. John's Tigers have done, and perhaps upbeating the tempo will play more to the favor of the Tigers than that of the Hornets, but only the second half will tell.
Okay, on the screen right now, the St. John's Tigers and Coach Rick Araska. Coach Araska is in his first year of coaching here at St. John's. He spent the last few years over at J.B. Mitchell Junior High School.
No pitcher.
Get our referees. There's Charlie Kurtz. Of course, Irv Hennick is standing in front of us. We wish Irv would move out of the way. Ron Burley throws that tip off. It goes off of Cassidy. He's one of the St. John's players. He can go out of bounds to the Tech Valk Hornets, and they've got a chance to regain the lead. They led by 3 points at one time in the first half. They've been down by as many as eight. We've had 9 lead changes in the game. We're looking for number 10 right now as Glenroy Reeler has control. His shot won't go. Finally, St. John's comes away with it. Linsky.
Good job by the Tech Valk Hornets. What they've done is they've come back with their starting five, and right away we had Cesar Tintanko go to their bread and butter man, Chris Bell. Unfortunately for the Hornets, Chris wasn't able to convert. Down at the other end, we can see that St. John's are coming out doing exactly the same thing. What they want to do is they want to go right down inside to their big men, and that's what they managed to do. And Rick Twilinski will be at the line to try and put the Tigers ahead by three.
He was fouled in the play by number 15, Ron Burley. That's Ron Burley's first personal foul, the team's first this half. Linsky misses, or makes the first one, pardon me. He's looking for number two here. comes up a little long and bounces off. Kirkhoff comes away with it. They've got a chance to tie it once again. Trickett, number 14, in control of the ball right now. They feed it down to Burley in the corner. Burley sitting up in the baseline. That ball around. Wheeler's wide open as he steps inside. Looks like another little charge. Yes, he got a charge down there. 22, Glenmore Wheeler pushing up that charge. That's his first personal, the team's second this half.
Good job by number 21, Rick Trulinski, to stand in there. That's the third or fourth time that we've seen an example of how to take the charge properly. And of course, with the change in the new rule, the basket on a charge does not count.
Fine defensive play by both teams. Two very well-coached teams here in the North Division Conference of the City of Winnipeg. Trying to move the ball down inside. They get it thrown off the glass there. Number 10 taking that shot, Petrie, but it won't go. Fighting for the rebound. Trulinski's there in that steal. Good steal there by Wanderwich. Gets it to Trulinski. He now has 12 points in the game.
Good look there by Wanderwich. Unfortunately for Ron Burley, after such a strong defensive rebound, he unfortunately lost the handle and was just double-teamed there by Trulinski and Wanderwich.
That shot up, he gets it downside. Trickett stepping inside, tried to force that ball through. It was taken away, and quickly the Tigers come the other way. Nacio feeds that ball off. Ball has lost control. Trulinski lost control as he moved towards the basket. 33-29, 6 minutes 22 seconds remaining in the third quarter, and you're watching freshman boys action from the St. John's Gymnasium. This is Blair Dugray along with Lori May, bringing you the best in high school basketball here on BPW Channel 13 Sports.
Good defense here by the Tigers. What they've done, of course, is managed to, once they score, go into a 1-3-1 half-court trap, which is putting a lot of pressure on the Hornets. After the trap, they simply drop back into a 2-3 zone now.
Bronco steps inside, fires it down to Burley. Burley from the baseline jumper, it won't go. Chris Bell comes down with a rebound off the glass. He's having trouble with it, fighting for the ball, and the Tigers come away with it.
Good job by St. John's in terms of blocking out there. However, what they're going to have to do, if they're going to go 2-3 zone, they've got to watch that weak side of the zone because they could be in trouble. And that's where Coach DiCurzio has number 21, Chris Bell, and it could cause some problems as the game wears on.
St. John's slowing the play down a little bit. They lead by 4 right now. Number 22, they're in control of the ball. Wanderwich, he took a little extra step. See number 23, Mike DeLorme, come back into the game. He replaces 21, Chris Bell.
Unfortunately for Chris Bell, he's been unable to hit down at the offensive end. So, of course, DeCozier is trying to bring in some more firepower and bring in Mike DeLorme, and it pays off with the first time that DeLorme touches the ball.
Mike DeLorme answers the bell. He now has 6 points in the game. Basket by Mike DeLorme, number 23. Nice move at the baseline. Castries drives inside, saw a little bit of opening. He gets 2 points and he's fouled on the play. Take a look at that on replay. A nice move there by number 11, Castries Castries from the Tigers as he moved inside. Let's take a
look on this replay. What we're going to see is a good job breaking the pressure here by Ignacio. Ignacio puts it over to Castries. He takes it right to the hole, and he's going to go to the line now for a 3-point play as he catches the all of the Hornets standing around watching.
Castries does not complete the 3-point play, but St. John's comes away with it. They get another opportunity. That's 3 shots now there by number 10. Finally, Trulinski puts it in. Petrie took 3 shots. Trulinski got the 4th rebound and put it in for 2 points. He leads all scorers with 14 points, 37-31, a 6-point lead now for the Tigers.
Good, excellent job of offensive rebounding there by St. John's, and here they can do it at the defensive end. I'm afraid the Hornets are starting to just simply stand around, and they're going to have to adjust very quickly here, or they're going to find themselves in trouble.
Trulinski with another offensive rebound. This time Trickett takes it away. St. John's gains control.
Good presence of mind there by Roland Ignacio. Instead of just taking down to the baseline and firing up, what he does is going to reset the offense here.
Nice move inside there, number 15, moving inside. Nacio got a basket again and a foul. Nacio on a good job of getting inside. Saw a little bit of opening, took it up.
Coach DiCurzio here is going to have to take a timeout fairly quickly. He's taking one out right now. What he's got to do is he's got to tell his ball players. They're just simply standing around. They've got the best seat in the house. If this 4:19 left in this third quarter, the big story here has been the unbelievable job that the three big men for St. John's have done in terms of offensive and defensive rebounding, especially number 21, Rick Twolinski. What we're going to do here is we're going to see an example of this in terms of Roland Ignacio here is going to make some penetration. And then what we're going to have is we're going to see the good offensive positioning by number 21, Rick Twolinski. And right there, he gets the basket, and he's going to be going to the line after we finish with this timeout to convert the three-point play.
4 minutes, 19 seconds remaining, 39-31, an eight-point lead for the Tigers. That ties their largest lead of the game, and they've got a chance to move it to 9 points. Twolinski is going to go to the line and attempt to complete a three-point play as he got that rebound off of that shot by Ignacio. Nice move inside. It's fouled by number 15, Ron Burley. That's his second personal foul, the team's fourth this half.
After converting this three-point play, if Rick Twolinski is successful enough in doing so, I expect to see the Hornets come out in some very fierce man-to-man defense, especially in their own half of the court. I expect the pressure to probably be man-to-man as well. On the other side of the coin, we've got to watch this 1-3-1 trap by the Tigers, and then when they fall back into the 2-3 zone, what we're going to have to do is see the Tigers attack it, Hornets attack it very quickly.
14, Cricket from the baseline for 2 points. He now has 12 in the game. Petrie gets it back to Castries, who's standing at the top. St. John's can afford to be a little more patient now, but they've done a good job of running, and there's Castries, that turnaround jumper. He has 16 points on a good turnaround jump shot from the free throw line. At number 11, also Castries.
Castros is doing one heck of a job on number five, Cesar Tentanko for the Hornets. What is going to have to happen there is Coach DiCurzio is going to have to try and equalize that somehow, perhaps with bringing number 21, Chris Bell, back into the game and letting number 14, Dwayne Trickett, play the point guard position.
In violation of number 10, Richard Petrie for the Tigers. Tech Boston to gain control. They brought number 11, Julius Eugene, into the game. Shooting potential from the outside. You just shot Trickett and throw up a shot along with Eugene. They both didn't go down. Johns came away with it. Clock managed to get it on the violation. The ball's turned over once again by the Hornets. 42-33, 3 minutes 15 seconds now remaining in the third quarter. Johns with a 9-point lead. That's their largest lead of the game. They've got control of the ball. Steal there, number five. Taco moves inside. Nice drive for 2 points. He now has 4 points in the game. Seeing that pressure, Coach May talked about it. Ball was almost lost there by Tigers, but they managed to regain control.
We can see what's happening here from the Hornets. They're playing a 3-2. What we have is the top two guards are playing man-to-man on the ball, and we have the back three big men, DeLorum, Eugene, and Trickett, playing a three-man zone. After the Hornets turn the ball over and score, they go to full-court man-to-man pressure, and they almost had a turnover there a little bit earlier.
They lose the ball this time in a back-over-center violation. No, we've got a holding foul.
The big man in that case, number 10, Richard Petrie, just was a little too over-anxious. He probably would have had Cesar Tentanko on a back-over-center call, but he just couldn't resist reaching in there and got caught.
Richard Petrie picking up his second personal foul, the team's first of this half. Into the game is number four. Senator Tabarrario coming into the game. Tavernario, number four, coming in the game for the Tigers. Right now, Tech Brock has it at the baseline. Take a shot, DeLorme for the rebound for 2 points. 23, Mike DeLorme now has 8 points in the game, and there's that pressure. Quickly, Tech Brock's putting on the pressure. St. John's having trouble breaking it. They almost lose control. They get it back, and they go for an easy 3 points at the other end. Petrie has 4 points now in the game.
Unfortunate turn of events for the Hornets there. They did what they wanted to offensively. They got the easy bucket from the weak side, and they did put the pressure on, which and it should have caused a turnover. Unfortunately, number 14, Dwayne Trickett, was unable to hold on to that, and number 10, Richard Petrie, was able to convert at the other end for the St. John's Tigers.
They fire the ball up court. Nice move inside there by number 15, Roland Ignacio. He's blocked on the play by number 15, Ron Burley, picking up his third personal, the team's fifth.
Once again, we have the Tech Bock Hornets standing around just a little bit too long. What we had was a good up-court pass by number 22, Larry Wodanowicz, to number 15, Roland Ignacio, and he has the presence of mind to go right at the big man, Ron Burley. Ron Burley, unfortunately, coming across far too late, was out of defensive positioning.
Ignacio hits the first of that bonus shot. He'll get another one. He now has 3 points. Just looking for number four, if he can hit the back end of this bonus. Makes them both from the line. We've got a violation. No basket, so it will not count. So the score of the minute and 45 seconds remaining is 45-37. 8-point lead for the Tigers over the Hornets. Trickett, once again, is free. This time he doesn't take that shot. Feeds it out to DeLorme. DeLorme's shot goes off the back iron. It won't go down. And DeLorme following in for the rebound. Picks up the foul. That'll be his second personal foul, and that'll send the Tigers back down to the bonus line.
Number 14, Dwayne Trickett, unfortunately for the Hornets, started to become a little apprehensive as far as shooting was concerned. He was right there at the foul line, 15 feet away, and he can easily shoot from there, as we saw earlier in the first half. Some of the shots that he started to can, it shows he's one of the better freshman shooters in the league, and he should have taken it there.
Number 22, Larry Wondowicz from the bonus line. He can't get it to go. He has only 2 points right now, the big 6'2" in center, but he's done a good job on the boards, and that's managed St. John's to gain control of this game. Wondowicz from the outside. There's number 3 and 4 for him as he sinks that one.
Excellent job of ball movement there by number 15, Roland Ignacio. What we can see is the swarming defense that the St. John's Tigers is employing here on the ball. They don't want to give the Hornets time to set up in any way, and as a result, they're putting an immense amount of pressure on the ball itself.
Right now, Tekwak in control. As we move inside a minute, 10-point lead for the Tigers. They're trying to get the ball to Burley. It won't go. Trickett fighting for the ball. Trickett and Wondowicz fighting, and they're going to jump it up. Good job and good hustle by both men. 14, Dwayne Trickett from the Tekwak Hornets, and 22, Larry Wondowicz of the St. John Tigers. They're going to go to the line to jump this one up.
Number 22, Larry Wondowicz, has played himself one heck of a ball game on the defensive end, and he's been complimented by number 21, Rick Tulinski, at the offensive end of the floor.
Jump there to number 22, Wondowicz. He gets the ball off to the Tigers. They gain control. Roland Ignacio is setting up the offense right now. Nice pass inside. Petrie is wide open for 2 points at the baseline. He now has 6 points in the game.
In this third quarter, the St. John's Tigers have come out and put immense pressure on the ball. They've done everything right offensively. Defensively, with that pressure, they've caused the Hornets either to turn the ball over or force them into taking poor shots. Number 14, Dwayne Trickett, just cans one there. That's what he has to do more of. On three separate occasions, he passed the ball off. He can't do that anymore. He's got to shoot the basketball.
Dwayne Trickett from the outside picks up his 14th point of the game. St. John's loses control in that long pass as Tekwak is putting pressure on after each basket. We're down to 10 seconds now remaining, 49-39. 10-point lead for the Hornets. They move inside 10. Tekwak is looking to score that last basket. Trickett again from the outside. Try to get down to Burley. It tips off and Burley gets it. From the outside, Burley's shot won't go. Fighting for the ball. Going to have a jump ball. Ball is knocked out of bounds at the end of the third quarter. Score after three quarters of play. The St. John's Tigers 49, the Tekwak Hornets 39. 8 minutes of freshman boys basketball remaining. What's Tekwak going to have to do to get themselves back in this game, Coach May?
What they're going to have to do, first of all, is defensively, they're going to have to start to play a little bit of defense. We can see that some of the penetration, either with the entry pass or the dribble, has managed to really hurt the Hornets. It's caught them flat-footed. It's caught them sleeping. What we have is a lot of second and third effort by the St. John's Tigers down at the offensive end of the floor, and the Hornets defensively haven't been able to counteract that. Coach DiCurzio right now has got to be emphasizing to his Chargers, as you can see on the screen, the fact that we got to play some defense, and that's simply all there is to it. That's what's kept them in the top five in the province, and that's what's the only thing that's going to save them with 8 minutes left in this game. St. John's, on the other hand, with the 10-point lead, what Coach Araska is going to be telling them right now, as you can see on their screen, is the fact that offensively they must feel that they're in pretty good shape, as they've been able to score just about any time they want. What he wants to tell them is defensively we've got to make sure that we don't give up any easy points, and offensively just simply execute. I expect to see a very fast-paced last 8 minutes of this game.
Hey, one quarter remaining in this freshman boys action. St. John's Tigers and the Tekwak Hornets right now. St. John's in control of the 10-point lead. Getting set to throw this one up. We see the back of referee Kurtz there. He moves down inside. Number 15, Burley. Number 21, Terinsky. He's going to throw that one up. Trickett comes away with it. Chance to move within eight. He would have looked over quickly. Murphy was open, but he takes it towards the baseline himself. Fires the ball back out. Trickett gets it inside. He's been trying to get that ball inside to Burley, and that's the third or fourth occasion that the ball's been knocked away. St. John's managed to gain control.
Dwayne Trickett will be able to get that ball in to Ronnie Burley a lot easier if he starts to shoot the ball and makes a few of them. There we go again, number 10, Richard Petrie, just as 21, Rick Chulinski, and 22, Larry Wodonowicz have been able to do all game. They've been doing an excellent job of offensive rebounding.
Petrie now has 8 points. Nice rebound down inside for two. Murphy tried to fire that one across. Alarm is there to get that deflection, though. They bring the ball back out once again. Trickett's open. He takes that jumper, and this time it goes off the back iron. Quickly, St. John's fires that ball up court. The ball's going to go out of bounds. That pass was intended for Roland Ignacio. Ball was a little too far for him. Tech Bucks going to regain control at the side. They're trailing by 12 points. We've got 7 minutes now remaining in the game.
It's good to see Dwayne Trickett, although he didn't manage to make that shot. It's good to see him start shooting again. He's got to start to shoot more often.
Early gets that ball inside. This time, nice pass down low from Trickett. Trickett's got it out, steps towards. He's going to take that shot, fires it across. DeLorenz all by himself for 2 points.
Here comes a full-court man pressure by the Hornets. We're going to see this every time that they score from now on. Panares does exactly what they want. There's the turnover. Good presence of mind by Dwayne Trickett to slow it up. They did not have any advantage on that break. And what they've got to do now is they've got to take advantage of this turnover and score an easy bucket somewhere along the line.
Trickett from the outside for two. It won't go. And there's a foul on the St. John's Tigers, number 22, Larry Wodonowicz, picking up his first personal foul. That's the team's second of this half. None of the St. John's players are in foul trouble. Players with two fouls are Richard Petrie and Rick Chulinski. They're the only two players with more than one foul. The team only has two in this half. While at the other end of the court, the Hornets have put the Tigers in the bonus line. Roland Trickett from the line hits for his 15th point of the game. He's just as deadly from that free throw line as he is from anywhere in the court. Fine shooting freshman here for the Tech Rock Hornets. Hits them both from the line. Now has 16 points in the game, and there's that pressure.
Here comes that pressure by the Hornets, and as we can see, it's giving the Tigers a little bit of a problem. However, that lack of defensive positioning early in the third quarter is going to probably come back to haunt the Hornets here, is when they put pressure on, they can't afford to foul. And the reason they can't is because they did not play defense in the third quarter, and as a result, they got themselves in the bonus situation very early. As a result, they're putting themselves in a very, very tight situation where they want to play the aggressive man-to-man, but they can't be too overly aggressive, or the St. John's Tigers will be going to the other end to shoot the bonus all night.
Sergio Taco picking up his second personal foul, and as we said, the Tigers will be at the bonus line. This time they can't convert, but they come away with that offensive rebound. Walensky, once again fighting inside, has to come down with it. His shot won't go, and the Hornets come back the other way. They're trailing by 8. We've got 6 minutes remaining in the game. Taco right now, they're looking to move within 6. Dwayne Trickett steps inside. A nice shot from the outside, number 14. Dwayne Trickett, he has 18 points to lead all scorers in the game.
Just what Wayne Trickett manages to do there, that's what we've got to see more of. A nice try by number 10 there, Gerald Murphy, to try and save that ball. We're going to be pretty close to a 10-second count here coming up, but the Tigers do manage just to get it across the timeline.
They throw that one away on a bad pass down underneath. A lot of pressure being put on by the Tech Park Hornets. They've got a chance now to move within 4. Starting to come back as we move down inside 5 minutes and 30 seconds. Trickett again from the outside. Tried to get to Burley once again. They fire the ball quickly up court. There's number 15. Nice move inside Ignacio for 2 points. He has 5 points in the game, and that relieves a little bit of pressure that the Tigers are feeling.
Right now, a nice feed inside by Murphy to DeLorum. Here comes the full court pressure by the Hornets again.
Mike DeLorum now with 12 points. They bring that one up rather quickly. Nice pass down inside. Ricky's down for 2 points. Number 21, Rick Kulinski, picking up his 19th point of the game. He now leads all the scores in the game with 19 points. 55-47, a shot from the outside by Trickett, won't fall down. This time, Wodonowicz is there for the rebound. And quickly, the Tigers come up court all by himself. Number 4 there, Junior Tenario takes it, but shot goes a little too hard. It's off the glass. Tech ball comes down the other way. Trailing by 8 points, he can move within 6 with a basket here. DeLorean is wide open again for 2 points. You have to do something about that. That weak side is having a lot of trouble for the St. John's Tigers. DeLorean has now picked up 6 points at the last minute. He's knocked out of bounds by the Tigers. We got some subs coming into the game for both teams.
Of course, for St. John's, they're going to bring in number 11, Celso Zastri. What he's going to do is replace number 4 for the Hornets, Werner Tiberio, because of the fact that he's a much better ball handler. On the other side of the coin, Coach DiCurzio, what he's looking at, of course, is bringing in some smaller, quicker players and try and cause a few more turnovers. As you can see on your screen right now, what Coach DiCurzio is trying to emphasize is that the man-to-man pressure that the Hornets are famous for is going to have to be applied a lot quicker than it's being done after they manage to score. Offensively, he's got to be telling them that they've got to get the ball to Dwayne Trickett, let him shoot it a little bit more. What he's managed to do is he's managed to put DeLorme, one of his top rebounders, on the offside. And as we have seen throughout the game, DeLorme has done a lot of damage on the weak side there. As far as the Tigers are concerned, with 4 minutes and 28 seconds left in the game, they do have themselves a comfortable lead. And hopefully they'll be able to sustain enough pressure on the Tech Clock Hornets and execute enough on their offense that they'll be able to maintain that six-point lead.
55-49, that six-point lead Coach May talked about. 4 minutes, 20 seconds remaining. Tech Clock has a chance to move within 4. Trickett trying once again to get the Burley. Look like he pushed off. The shot won't go down, and St. John's comes away with the rebound.
Well, number 15, Ron Burley, got away with one there. He pushed off there, certainly no doubt about it. He gave Petrie a good push in the back, but fortunately for him, he wasn't called at all.
Petrie took that shot, got his own rebound, passed it down low inside to Estes, and he picked up the foul down underneath as he was fouled as he went towards the basket. He's going to go to the line to shoot two.
Celso Zastri was actually lucky there to come out with a chance at the foul, and I'm pretty sure that Coach Araska got off the bench there. What he would have liked to seen was Zastri just simply dribble out of trouble and set up the offense and run a little bit more time off the clock. The most valuable portion of that play, of course, though, was the follow by number 10, Richard Petrie, and the St. John's Tigers have been able to hurt the Hornets on the boards of both the offensive and defensive end.
Astor hitting both of those from the line. He now has 18 points. That foul was on number 15, Ron Burley. That's his fourth personal. Looks like he could have had a back over center violation, but there was no call there. So he stopped right at the midcourt line, but he threw the ball out of bounds anyways. St. John's has control. They can expand that 8-point lead to 10 once again. With 3 minutes and 40 seconds now remaining. Moving towards the baseline, Castries takes that shot. It's a little long. Trickett fighting for the rebound. And I think number 10 went over top there, Richard Petrie, and he picks up his third personal foul, and that's the team's third of this half. Still, will not put the Hornets down to the bonus line, so they can do no damage. The Tigers from down there.
Freshman's mistake there by number 11, Celso Zastri. There's no need to force that along the baseline with the 8-point lead that they have. Let's just simply work our offense and try and melt the clock here a little bit.
Shot from the outside there. Number 13 coming into the game now, Gene Million. Takes that shot, comes up a little short, and got another foul down underneath.
Good work by number 14, Dwayne Trickett, in terms of getting himself some good offensive rebounding positioning. What we have on the floor for Tech Vauk right now, of course, is two very small but very quick guards, and Burley and DeLorme to do the board work, and Trickett to do the shooting for the Hornets. I would wonder why we haven't seen Chris Bell for the last quarter and a half. Perhaps one of the smaller guards could come off the floor and Dwayne Trickett could bring up the ball for them, and it would give them a lot more board strength, and also with Chris Bell being the athlete he is, give him the pressure that he would need in order to put on that man-to-man press.
Trickett hits one of two from the line. He now has 19 points. At last foul is number 10, Richard Petrie. He has 4 personal fouls. That was the fourth team foul, so the next foul on the Tigers will put the Hornets at the bonus line. Down to 3 minutes, 10 seconds remaining, 57-50, a 7-point lead for the Tigers. Hornets have control of the ball. They get it to Trickett in the corner. Looking once again for Burley, but this time Burley was caught with that little push from behind. He's done it the last two times down the court, and this time referee Irv Hanick picked that one up.
Good call by referee Hanick there on the baseline.
Game are finished.
Good call by referee Hanick there on the baseline. What we've had is we've had Ron Burley managed to get away with that a couple times. Last time down, we've got a very good shot of it by our cameraman in terms of the push-off. Referee Hanick positioned on the baseline there, caught him for that time.
Well, I've got Tech Vauk number 15, Ron Burley, with 5 fouls, but I see at the score bench here, he only has 4. Coach May, did you know how many fouls went ahead with him? Well, we'll wait for Coach Coach Mays answered earlier. Tech Fox almost throws that ball away.
Tech Fox really having trouble handling the different types of pressure that St. John's has thrown at them. They've gone three-quarter court man-to-man. They've gone a 2-2-1, and they've also gone 1-3-1 half-court trap, and it's been successful for St. John's quite a bit.
Trickett open from the outside for 2 points. Trickett now has 21 points in the game, and he leads all scorers. Quickly, they fire that ball in. They almost lose control. Trying to get across that midcourt line, and they do. Wondowitz gets it down inside. Walensky, and that shot's blocked. 7-point lead right now for the Hornets. They can move it down to 5 as we move to 5:15. Drew Million loses control. Taco from the outside, and his shot won't go. Fighting for the rebound. Burley comes away with it. He's open. Steps towards the baseline. He's going to bring it back out again. It's Trickett now. Shot from the top. Force that one up, and it won't go down. They're fighting for the rebound. St. John's comes away with it. We've moved inside. 2 minutes now remaining in this game. 59-52, 7-point lead for the Tigers over the Hornets.
Roland Ignacio doing the right thing here, bringing the ball up. What these two guards have got to do is they've got to calm down in terms of that. Well, that's one shot that I'm pretty sure that Coach Araska holds his breath on. In this timeout, I think Coach Araska wants it just as bad as Coach DiCurzio. His two guards, number 15, Roland Ignacio, and number 11, Celso Zastri, what they've got to do is they've got to learn how to control the play. With them being up 9 points and just over a minute and a half left in the game, there's really no need to score anymore. Let's execute. Let's run our offense and let the clock be our guide. They couldn't ask for anything better. They are in the bonus situation. Tech Vok is going to have to start to foul them, so why do we have to shoot the ball? There's simply no need for it.
Minute and 41 seconds remaining, 61-52, a 9-point lead for the Tigers. We take a look at Coach DiCurzio and the Tech Vok bench. They've got a minute and 41 to get themselves back in the game. They have to put on a lot of pressure. So are they going to be able to do it, Coach May?
Well, the Tech Vok Hornets, as we said, have been known for their man-to-man pressure. It's something that Coach DiCurzio teaches very well over there at Tech Vok. They have very good athletes. The one thing that I would wonder about is the absence of Chris Bell over the last quarter and almost three quarters of the third quarter as well. He's someone that can do a job for them on the boards. He's an excellent athlete, and he would simply make available that physical ability to put the press on. And I would think that he would have substituted Chris Bell for number five, Cesar Tentanko, and hopefully...
Chris Bell is still not back in the game, and that seems kind of strange because he did play well right from the very beginning. They used him down low to get the ball to him to set up. Jack Boston gained control of the football violation on the Tigers. Down to a minute and 34 now remaining. That was almost taken away. Good job of defense there. Okay, stepping inside. Malco steps down. Glenroy Wheeler with the ball at the baseline right now. Gets around, he's trying to force his way in, but he's pushing with his hand, and he pushes off, he picks up the offensive foul, number 22, Glenroy Wheeler, and that's his second personal. I mean, no shot on that, as that is a player control foul.
Well, what DiCurzio did there was to do a substitution, but I'm still surprised to see that it would be Glenroy Wheeler instead of number 21, Chris Bell.
Wheeler tries to take that one away, but number 22 is there down the floor, and he picks up that foul for the Tigers. Larry Wondowicz picking up his second personal foul. That's going to send the Hornets down to the bonus line with a minute and 14 seconds remaining.
These two foul shots by Glenn Wheeler are going to be very important. If he manages to make these two, it's going to put the Hornets only down 7 with a minute and 14 left in the game. And with the way that they can cause turnovers, the game's by no means over.
Can't get that one to drop. And St. John's comes away with a rebound. A good job of boards there by Petrie. Petrie receives that return pass. Wondowicz gives it right back to him. They get it across the midcourt line. And hopefully St. John's will be very patient with their offense. As we move inside a minute, there's no need for them to take a shot right now. They can do a good job of moving that ball around, keeping opening. They got to keep looking at the basket. They fire that one, and Tech Vok knocks it out of bounds.
Once again, Yara, you can see number 15, Roland Ignacio, look down towards the baseline. There's simply no need for that. All they have to do is just simply kill the clock. There was no need for him to look down the baseline. You put the ball down on the baseline, you're going to just simply get trapped down there. Into the game for St. John's, we have number 12, Jim Penner. He's going to come in and replace who I think has been the player of the game for St. John's, number 21, Rick Terlinski.
Penner must be a fan favorite because the crowd was quite happy to see him come off of the bench. good-sized crowd here for this midweek action in the North Division. Freshman boys action, St. John's and Tech Vaux. Tech Vaux, the number 22, Glenroy Wheeler, takes inside for 2 points. That's his first 2 points of the game. He's going to get a chance for point number three and four as he makes that steal. 61-56, a five-point lead. We're down to 25 seconds remaining. And Coach May, we both just about ate another basketball. It's the third time in a few days that we've had a basketball fall in our lap.
But just as we said during the WIT, we wish our executive producer, Morris Glimcher, would be up here to set a screen for us. Fortunately, I was able to get some quick hands there and save Mr. Dugray, but if we were lucky enough to have our security blanket, and I'm talking an extra big blanket here, Morris Glimcher, we wouldn't have these problems with these errant basketballs.
Well, I talked to Mr. Glimcher during the week, and he informed me that he was going to try to make it out here. And if he does make it out here, we're going to set him right in front of us, and we'll have no problems for the rest. That'll be like a cage match in wrestling. We'll be all boxed in. We won't have to worry about it. That's probably true. We won't be able to see too much. One of our technicians in the booth will be able to see the play, but at least we'd be safe. 16 seconds remaining, 61-56. The ball's knocked out of bounds by St. John's. Tech Vaux in gain control with 16 seconds, got to score 5 points. There's still a fair amount of time to get that ball, get it back. Any kind of foul, 3-point play. Glenroy Wheeler gets it to Lorem. That shot from the baseline comes up a little short. They're fighting for that rebound. Now within five, they're trying to move it away. Looking for a quick foul now from Tech Vaux. There's the foul. They pick it up right there. Number five picking up that foul. Seagulls. Also, that's just about it. And they'll do it in for the Hornets. 3 seconds remaining in a 5-point lead. St. John's is going to go down to the bonus line. Right, the Tigers are number one. I think the Tigers, freshman boys, Tigers have played a fine basketball game today.
A good job by St. John's. A couple of things that I would wonder about is Coach Araska's two guards, number 11, Celso Zastri, and number 15, Roland Ignacio. If he can get them to execute offense a little bit better, I'm telling you they're going to be very tough to beat indeed.
Down, it's all run out at the buzzer. Number 14, Cricket throws that one up and it won't go down. The final score, the St. John's Tigers 61, the Tech Vaux Hornets 56. Coach, may your comments on this special boys game.
An excellent basketball game. We're looking at only a 5-point difference here. What we have, of course, the difference in the game was the ability of the St. John's Tigers to throw at Tech Vaux a number of different defenses in terms of man-to-man pressure and zone. The 1-3-1 half-court trap late in the first half, and the four players playing a zone and the man-to-man on Dwayne Trickett to stop him early in the game worked very well for Coach Araska. Tech Vaux, fortunately, had problems in not only handling the pressure, but also when it came to playing defense. It seemed that Tech didn't quite want to win this game as badly as St. John's, and the major difference in the game was St. John's ability to control the glass at either end, and one of the players that was able to do that the best for St. John's was number 21, Rick Trilinski, who I think without a doubt was the player of the game for the St. John's Tigers. This is a league confrontation, of course, that's very important to both teams, but both of these teams we're going to see in the provincials, there's no doubt about it, and with approximately a month left in the season, both of these teams are going to get a lot better than they are, and I could easily see one of these two playing in the freshman provincial final.
Fine basketball game, 61-56. The Tigers defeat the Hornets in freshman boys action. We'll be back in a moment with the varsity boys game from the St. John's Gymnasium.